morning. So today I want to take a little time to explain the difference between a chemtrail and a contrail. A lot of people have a problem understanding that difference because contrails are natural, produced by jets and cars actually, and chemtrails are not. So when I'm walking down the street and I see an obvious chemtrail, I'll stop somebody and I'll point up there and I'll say, "Do you know what that is?" And they'll say, "An exhaust from a jet." Some of them know the term contrail. And then I tell them that, you know, in the winter time when you drive your car and the hot exhaust comes out of your car and you get like a steam kind of effect coming out the back of the car, I said, that would be like a contrail. I said, and when jets fly up in the air, you know, it's cold up there. So the same concept takes place. The exhaust is hot and it turns into a vapor kind of thing. And it's an exhaust that's known as a contrail. I said, but think of this. Let's say your car has this smoke coming out of the back and you're driving 20 miles to work. And when you look back, that smoke has traveled 20 miles with you, behind you for the whole 20 miles. It's still there, hasn't dissipated. Okay, so that's a little bit different than following you as you're driving. When you watch an airplane up there that's got a contrail, it follows and dissipates. A chemtrail stays there and it begins to spread out. And eventually the blue sky turns hazy. So that's the difference. You can tell a chemtrail. All right, I hope that helps. Have a good day and stay safe.